What's up guys, it's Justin here, and today I'm very excited to bring you a series that I've been planning since the start of the year, and I'm very excited to finally show you, and that is the setup makeover. If you guys didn't know already, I really love to do setup tours and just create setups all the time, and I've done quite a few this summer and plan to do many more. What I really want to do with this series though is find a setup that has quite a bit of potential and at least has the core items but could definitely use a lot of work. The objective is really to clean it up, add some fresh furniture, a new coat of paint, and also some accessories that just add to the functionality, but most importantly, also have the personal touch in mind based on what the person likes. So what I've done is just try to gather some information and design a setup that I think would go very well based on what we can already reuse. But otherwise, make sure you subscribe to the channel and also leave a like on this video if you enjoy this type of series, and maybe in the future I'll open it up to you guys to possibly have me fly down and redo your setup and I'll pay for everything. So the first episode takes us all the way to Silver Spring, Maryland, and we're going to be redoing a setup of my editor Vin's friend Diego.
What's up? My name's Diego, and I love making YouTube videos. I make vlogs every single day, and I love making films so much that I got a camera tattooed on my arm. For the most part, my setup isn't the greatest. It's been pretty much ghetto rigged from things I've found throughout my life. I'm trying to make sure that it's the best as it can be, but I definitely need some help.
So my first reaction when I saw this setup is, holy crap, there's a lot of things on this desk. And my desk does get messy from time to time, but this is something that I've never seen before. It is literally like, holy f***, like there's a lot of stuff on this desk, and some of which you have no idea how long it's been there for. I just can't describe the amount of clutter, random things just laying all around, and also some food items as well, which kind of worries me. The wall is also a bit of an odd color, the shelves don't really match, and the table itself is held by a set of stools. But regardless of all the clutter, the centerpiece of the setup is a MacBook Pro Retina 13-inch, and you also have a dual display setup here, so I think it's definitely something that I can work with. So whether you're completely transforming your setup or not, one starting point for anything is just to clean it up. This is something that I definitely need to do more often, and I typically clean my office every 1 to 2 weeks or when I'm done filming. With Diego's setup though, you can tell that he's waited a little bit longer than that, and it seems like an accumulation of things over the years, and as you can see, after we removed everything, the desk was still really dirty with just random dust, and it was quite disgusting. But instead, we got rid of some old books, trophies, trash, and more trash. That definitely took a while. When it comes down to breaking down the budget for my plan and design, we start out with the paint, which costed about $62, and this includes some of the supplies, including the brush, rollers, and also some green tape. We went with a very standard white because that seems like it's going to be the overall theme for the setup. When it comes to our accessories, we got a monitor arm which had great reviews and wasn't too expensive for what it was, also a J channel for the cables, a headphone hanger for Diego's Audio-Technica M50s, and also an Anchor 4-port USB 3.0 hub which I think will just reduce the clutter as well. These items were all ordered on Amazon and the grand total for that section came out to $77. As for the artwork, we went on Etsy and got a digital copy of 2 different posters and had them printed locally, and the total cost for that was $32. For furniture, Diego already had some pre-existing furniture in the setup from IKEA, including the desktop and also the shelf, so we decided to stick with IKEA for this setup. The names of each products are going to be on screen because I can't pronounce these Swedish names, but we got a set of actual legs for his desk, a matching white shelf for one side, a set of paper organizers, bins, and also a set of lamps for the setup, and the IKEA portion costed $194. So in total, we spent $365 and just over $300 if you don't have to repaint your walls. And of course, there's a few things here and there that you can decide whether or not you need. At the end of the day, the goal was really to transform the setup, but also reuse elements such as the bookshelf and also the desktop, and everything else essentially was replaced in this situation. Of course, we needed a lot of space to work with, so after removing all of the stuff and just getting the clutter out of the way, we went to IKEA and got the furniture. IKEA is definitely a place where you end up browsing and getting a whole bunch of other stuff that you just really don't need, so I definitely suggest planning out what you need before you go and just go and pick it up and don't look at anything else. After getting lost in IKEA, we had all the supplies we needed, including the paint, and it was time to just literally get rid of everything, move it away from the wall, and just start painting this wall. Because this wall was blue, it definitely took quite a few layers and was a bit tougher than expected to get it to a white, but this really comes down to your setup and you might not have to paint your wall at all. After the paint dried, it was finally time to reconstruct the setup once again and put together some of the new furniture that we got. This included the one shelf, the set of legs, and just to place the existing desktop that Diego already had back on top of these legs, and I'm sure he was very happy that we got some actual legs for the setup. We also installed the monitor arm and had the monitors attached to that, which of course was VESA compatible, wrapped up some of the cables and had them go down the J channel to hide them, put the tech that he had before back on again, and also the hook for his headphones. Lastly, some of the finishing touches include just adding the decorations such as the posters, which had the Boston Celtics and also New York, adding some of the collectibles back onto the shelves, including his shoes and trophies. And in the end, made Diego promise that this setup will not ever be as messy as it was again. And I think it overall turned out really nicely and has a nice clean look to it, but also symmetrical on both sides. So without further ado, here's a before and after of Diego's setup. So as you can probably see, it's a very clean and simple look that I would like to go with. And normally with Mac setups, this is kind of the aesthetic that you guys know me for. I think the monitor arm was one of the most important purchases that we made, and it holds both of these monitors very nicely and works with any VESA compatible monitor. Since Diego's MacBook has actual ports on it, we decided to get a USB hub that was 3.0 compatible, and this is from Anker. And I think what's great about them is that they're very reliable and look great as well, so you can either have them behind and hidden in the J channel or just placed on your desk and it still looks clean. Next up, when it comes to shelves, we decided to have a mixture of storage, but also some areas that just reflect on what Diego likes. These shelves are very large and have tons of space, so you want to take advantage of that, so we made sure that we had some storage for Diego to keep his papers. Last but not least, since these shelves were so tall and the monitors weren't exactly the largest, there's a lot of empty space above the monitors. So we decided to get some posters that reflect on what Diego likes once again, which was the Boston Celtics and also New York. Really, the only thing that we had to do at this point was pick a wallpaper for both screens, and that is much harder than you think. I'm really someone who is really influenced by workspace, which is why I'm a firm believer in investing in your workspace, but let's go ahead and cut to Diego and see what he has to say about this setup and how it influences his daily life and also his productivity.
Finally, having everything super clean and actually in plain view helped so much. Before, it was super unorganized and I didn't know where anything was. And even the fact that my shoes are in view kind of helps me flex a little bit, which is pretty tough. Shouts out to Justin and his team for setting this entire thing up. I definitely needed this makeover really bad, as you can tell. I'm super thankful and I definitely don't think I could have been as productive from now on with my videos without you guys. Thank you so much, and I can't ask for more.
I think at the end of the day, this setup turned out really nicely and I'm really happy with the way it looked. What I like to do with any setup is just analyze it first, figure out what we can change and what we can do with a certain budget, and lastly, put it together and just take a look at what the transformation was from before and after. I think the setup turned out quite well, and the one thing that I would have added to it was actually to have an extra set of lights in the room because it was still quite dark. Otherwise, the entire setup went really smoothly and Diego was great to work with, but just leave a comment down below telling him to clean up his desk regularly or go ahead and comment that on his channel because we don't want to see an episode 2 of the same setup once again. But there's definitely a lot of things I want to do with this series and go even crazier and maybe even open up to entries for you guys and just fly down and I'll redo your entire setup on me and put together a plan. So go ahead and leave a comment down below, drop a like on this video, subscribe to the channel and all that. And I might do it in the future, but I definitely plan to do an episode 2 and continue to bring you guys some setup videos. I definitely had a lot of fun doing episode 1 though and hope you guys enjoyed it, but otherwise I'll see you guys in the next video.